education system or any school have a focus on developing these qualities, or they more focus on just academics? What do you think? That any school or present conventional education system focuses on development of these qualities? Unka focus is quality ki taraf hai? Yeah, that is on more on academics. Just on mastering of the more on academic parts. At Rushikul, along with academics, we focus on developing of these qualities to live a happy and successful life. Let us see how we do it. Okay. We have studied from 1st to 10th standard all. Everyone, what do we remember now? Almost nothing, simple mathematics. 2 plus 2, 4 and something. Anything else? Do we remember Newton's law? What were the Newton's law? Kya the Newton's law? Every action has equal and opposite reaction. Fine, wonderful. What else? What were the gravitational force? Story is connected, so gravitational force. What else? Do we remember anything from history, geography? Almost nothing. We have passed so many nights. SSC, we have scored 80-90%, but we have forgotten almost everything. Isn't it? And still we are happy and okay. We have forgotten and still we are happy and okay. Fine. Year mein Gandhi born hue the. Wonderful. 1869. One or two people. And actually if you have forgotten that, it doesn't matter too. But Gandhi ko train se dhakka maar ke utar dene mein aaya tha. Aur uske liye wo jo ladak shuru ki, wo usko mohon se Mahatma taraf leke gayi. Sabhi ko yaad hai? Hum log ne 25 baar ye yaad kiya tha aise likhne ke liye ki Gandhi 1869 mein born hue the. But we have forgotten. Humne ye yaad kiya tha कि उसको ट्रेन में से धक्का मारने पेपर के एग्जाम के लिए नहीं किया था, फिर भी हमें याद. तो जो भी हमारे जीवन के लिए जरूरी है वो हमें अपने आप याद रह ही जाता है, बाकी निकल जाता है. इट डजंट मीन कि हमें पढ़ना नहीं चाहिए. लेट एवरीथिंग कम, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड एंड लेट इट गो. अ बॉय हु रिमेंबर्स आफ्टर रिग्रेस स्टडी एंड गेट्स 80 or 90 मार्क्स, इवन ही फॉरगेट्स आफ्टर द 2 मंथ्स ऑफ एग्जाम एवरीथिंग. तो एग्जाम के 2 महीने के बाद भूलना है, तो व्हाई नॉट राइट नाउ? एग्जाम के 2 महीने के बाद ही भूलना है तो पहले ही भूल जाओ. क्या ये एग्जाम के लिए याद करना इतना प्रेशर, इतना एफर्ट, क्या हमें इंटेलिजेंट बनाएगा? वी ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवन हैड पास्ड थ्रू द नाइटमेयर दैट टुमारो इज द फिजिक्स एग्जाम एंड आई हैव प्रिपेयर फॉर द केमिस्ट्री. इजंट इट? आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ एग्जाम आल्सो वी यूज्ड टू हैव दिस नाइटमेयर. सो व्हाट दिस शोस? क्या बता रहा है ये? What this source? Stress, fear. Is it possible for anyone to grow in this stress or in this fear? Let's understand the same thing in a different way. Okay. What do you enjoy the most? किसी भी उम्र की व्यक्ति को सबसे ज्यादा मजा किस चीज में आता है? खेलने में. What else?
Music.
घूमना, डांस. सर्वे सेज ह्यूमन एंजॉय द मोस्ट इन लर्निंग न्यू थिंग्स. ह्यूमन एंजॉय द मोस्ट इन लर्निंग न्यू थिंग्स. सपोज देयर इज वन ओल्ड मूवी गोइंग, ओल्ड गुड मूवी विच यू आर सीइंग गोइंग ऑन एंड वन न्यू मूवी, वेयर डू यू लाइक टू गो फॉर? न्यू मूवी, राइट? सम बाय दिस टाइम वी हैव लर्न सम न्यू पॉइंट्स, यू हैव अंडरस्टूड सम न्यू पॉइंट्स, डिड इट गिव यू जॉय? राइट? So in learning new things, we get maximum joy. And children, they love to learn new and new things. And in school, they get to learn new things. But surprisingly, we are not able to see the joy of that on their faces. School में नया नया सिखाया भी जाता है, लेकिन उसकी खुशी उसके चेहरे पे दिखती नहीं है. क्यों? Burden. Burden of what? Burden of studies. Okay. कॉम्पिटिशन, एग्जाम्स, फियर ऑफ टीचर्स. ओके, व्हाट एल्स? कंपैरिजन बिटवीन द चिल्ड्रन. वंडरफुल. So, all are right, fine. One more thing what we have observed, all answers are right. One more thing what we have observed is that the lesson, the one story which has to be completed within one or two period goes for 4 to 5 periods. Again the mummy teaches the same, again the tuition teacher teaches the same, and again question answers while exam. By the time child would have enjoyed the 4 to 5 stories, child has to remain in a just one story mugula. स्टोरी का सबसे पहला हेतु था आनंद लेना, दूसरा हेतु था कुछ बोध लेना, दोनों को हमने साइड में छोड़ दिया, तीसरा हेतु पकड़ा क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर। सपोज मैं कहता हूं कि हम एक मूवी देखते हैं, वी एंजॉय द मूवी, नाउ आई विल आस्क यू सम क्वेश्चंस, यू हैव टू आंसर मी एंड दैट टू इन राइटिंग, एंड एवरी वीक विल सी अ ब्यूटीफुल मूवी। अब बोले बाबा मुझे मूवी नहीं देखना है, राइट? द सेम थिंग वी आर डूइंग विद द किड्स। सीखना सबसे आनंददायक है, दे लव टू लर्न न्यू एंड न्यू थिंग्स, और पूरा मजा हम खराब कर देते, किरकिरा कर दे बाय इवैल्यूएटिंग एग्जाम्स। आर यू गेटिंग इट? सीखना सबसे आनंददायक, दैट्स अ वेरी नेचुरल प्रोसेस। एक्चुअली किसी भी बच्चे का एग्जिस्टेंस ही क्या है? सीखना। यू ऑब्जर्व थ्रू आउट द डे 24 आवर्स दे आर लर्निंग। हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू ब्रीदिंग? No friends, here you are not breathing, it's going on. It's going on, you are not breathing. Let's breathe consciously. Come on, let's breathe consciously. What will happen? You will get tired after a minute or two. Same thing, learning is a very joyful thing, but when you make it conscious learning, it's tiring and boring. Are you getting it? When you are making it conscious, it becomes tiring and boring. And why you make it conscious? Just because of the exams. Otherwise, children enjoy the learning new things. वो सीखने में उनको मजा आ रहा है, सीख रहे हैं, and they are enjoying. लेकिन exam आती है, we have to do studies consciously. I'll tell you, there are two boys, Neil and Sagar. Both are studying in 4th standard. In the same class, the teacher is very excellent. They learn almost everything in the class itself. They understand well in the class itself. Neil parents are happy with that understanding. And Neil goes for the exam with just understanding. He read for just once or twice. Sagar parents, along with that understanding, are interested in some more teaching. He made him practice. He prepared him for the exam. Naturally, when the exam will come, the result will come. Neil will get 12 or 13 out of 20, and Sagar will get 17 or 18 out of 20. What do you think? Which score is better? 70 or a 12? Of course 70, isn't it? What is the problem if he has understood everything and his practice and his writing? What's wrong in that? Of course the 17 is better. Let's understand in a different way. For getting that extra 5 marks, Sagar has to study every day 1 hour extra and 5 hours extra before the exam. That was not his nature. That is not his child's nature to sit down and study, to keep repeating the things which he already knows, which he has already understood, to practice that. That is not a 4th standard child's nature. We are doing against his nature. He has been compelled to do that. It was a little bit torture on his part. And that extra 5 marks have not were on the just piece of paper, have not added anything in his intelligence or in his geniusness. It has made him only studious, not a genius. On the other part, Neil is free and enjoying cycling, enjoying playing cricket, football, reading books, or what he loves to do. And maybe those experiences would have added something in his intelligence directly or indirectly. What do you think? Yes. Friends, free time and play time is equally important as academic. And believe me, I have observed that in SSC or in further studies, Neil is far ahead than Sagar. Why? Just because he was phrased. And he was not unnecessarily not over exhausted in his childhood. Are you getting it? He was not unnecessarily over-exhausted in childhood. What do you think? Which score is better, Neil or Sagar? Sagar or Neil? Neil is a fail. Just after understanding, what do you think? Which is better? You like this, na? Right now, Sagar is in the 4th standard, okay? The 5th standard, I am able to score 15. Array, 17, 18. Now, I do not need to give attention to the teacher. Why? घर पे मम्मी प्रैक्टिस करा दी, हो जाता है, सब कुछ मार खा जाते हैं. क्या इतना सब समझने का टीचर सिखा दिया है? अरे, and he will give less attention to the understanding to the teacher. And he knows that if I will practice, I mean, whatever we say, practice as a mugging up or whatever, I will able to score good. What do you think? Which is better? Understanding is better, and the Sagar was also doing understanding with the and then making practice. But that is not a child nature. Understand, there is a difference between 4th standard child and a 7th standard child. There is a difference between 7th standard child and an 8th standard child. There is a difference between 8th standard child and a 9th standard child. And there is a huge difference between a 9th standard child and a 10th standard child. And we are expecting 4th standard child to do everything what 10th standard child will able to do. Are you getting it? Problem कहाँ है? अरे दसवीं तो अभी बहुत दूर है और ये चार ये फोर्थ में पढ़ रहा है 10 साल का बच्चा है दसवीं और वो आएगा जब वो 16 साल का रहेगा और वही सारी चीज हम एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं समझ गया है वो अपने हिसाब से लिखेगा वाई ये अगर उसको उसको अपने हिसाब से लिख रहा है 12-13 मार्क आ रहे हैं व्हाट इज हैपनिंग परफेक्टली लिखना है ये करना है दैट इज नॉट हिज नेचर एंड ग्रेजुअली विल देयर आर द इयर्स और ग्रेजुअली इट विल हैपन बट वो सब हम यहाँ चाहते और वहीं से प्रॉब्लम स्टार्ट होता है अरे हम लोग 17 मार्क के पीछे पड़े क्यों है मालूम है हु इज फेवरेट ऑफ टीचर सागर हु इज गेटिंग 17 दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एजुकेशन सिस्टम दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एजुकेशन सिस्टम दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ सोसाइटी बाजू वाला कुत्ता है आपको क्या रिजल्ट आया पहल बताने को तो थोड़ा गड़बड़ होगा तो 17 बताना है तो क्या कराना पड़ेगा बच्चे को दौड़ाना पड़ेगा घोड़े को दौड़ाना पड़ेगा हॉर्स विल नॉट एबल टू एंजॉय हिज लाइफ वी हैव टू मेक हिम रन इजंट इट एंड एट ऋषिकुल टीचर्स अवर गुरुजीस डू नॉट डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन देम ऑन द बेस ऑफ मार्क्स और ऑन द बेस ऑफ देयर परफॉर्मेंस दे लव इक्वली टू द ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स उतना ही सबसे प्यार करते हैं एंड दिस इज द बिगेस्ट फ्रीडम यू नो व्हाट हैपेंस कंटिन्यूअसली स्टूडेंट्स आर व्हाट दे आर ट्राइंग टू इंप्रेस द टीचर्स व्हेन दे नो द टीचर लव अस इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ व्हाट वी डू हाउ बेटर वी डू हाउ वेल वी डू टीचर लव अस सो दे आर फ्री फ्रॉम इंप्रेसिंग टीचर आर यू गेटिंग इट दैट्स द बिगेस्ट फ्रीडम दे आर गेटिंग एंड Rushikul's mummy are also trained on this part. Rushikul's parents also have been trained for this. They consider what? अच्छा आगे हमने पहले ही देखा दसवीं तक जिसको भी 80-90 जो भी मार्क आए रहते 80-90% सब कुछ भूल गए जितने भी मार्क आए थे जितनी भी रातें हमने दिन रात एक किए थे सब कुछ हो गया क्या बचा है फिर भी हम फर्स्ट क्लास है ओके सक्सेसफुली हैप्पीली जी रहे हैं सो अल्टीमेटली यार सोचते हो अरे बाप रे वो 8 में न्यूटन लॉ कर रहा था ना मुझे ऐसा लग रहा था अगर ये नहीं आया ना तो जीवन में कुछ कर ही नहीं पाऊंगा मतलब तभी लगता था कि ये अगर मैं मुझे नहीं लिख पा रहा हूं ना मैं बराबर वर्ड्स में एज इट इज तो मेरा तो लाइफ ही अटक जाएगा आगे लेकिन ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं हुआ फर्स्ट क्लास सब चल रहा है फाइन Yeah, bonding between the students and Guruji. This is Guru, this is called Guruji. The rapport between the teacher and students is so beautiful. Their intimacy is so well. Whatever teacher teaches, the children learn with the so intensity that it is they learn 10 times more than the routine class. क्योंकि उनके बीच में क्या है? एक bonding है, एक love है. उसके वजह से जब बच्चे सीखते हैं ना, तो उनका सीखने का intensity और grasping power इतना हो जाता है. They are able to learn 10 times more than the routine class. and by chance if they have not understood anything, easily raise their hand and clear their doubts. Rushikul teachers creates fearless and conducive environment for learning. We shifted our focus from marks. We means teachers, school, teachers, parents. Shifted focus from marks. As a result, children focus on understanding the concept. More than that, they enjoy learning. This is the secret of Rushikul's joyful learning. Children are literally enjoying the learning. और एक्चुअल में ये है ना कि सीखना जैसे आनंददायक चीज कुछ है ही नहीं. तो मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल थिंग अगर कुछ इतना कुछ समझ में आया, मजा आ रहा है कि नहीं आ रहा है, कुछ नया समझ में आया, मजा आ रहा है कि नहीं आ रहा है, सोचो बच्चों को कितना सीखने को मिल रहा है और कितना मजा आ रहा है. वो पूरा मजा कौन किसी का कर देता है? एग्जाम्स, अवर एक्सपेक्टेशंस, दोनों सीट्स पड़े दोनों सरफेस पे, दोनों फ्लोर पे सीट्स, कौन से सीट्स ग्रो होंगे? राइट सर, ये क्यों नहीं होंगे? Because it's a hard surface, it's a hard floor, right? And that is a fertile soil, isn't it? So what is a hard surface for a child that he will not able to grow, he will not able to bloom? What is that? Stress and fear, stress, fear, pressure. And what is a fertile soil where child will able to bloom very well, able to grow very well? That is the joy. Why the stress is there? Because of the hurry, दसवीं में आने वाला है, अरे अभी नहीं कर रहा, दसवीं में क्या करेगा? ठीक है, रेट रेस, वही टीचर को इंप्रेस करने के लिए, सोसाइटी पड़ोसी को इंप्रेस करने के लिए भागना, एक्सपेक्टेशंस, कंपल्शंस, इट क्रिएट्स अ स्ट्रेस. एंड व्हाट इज जॉय? फ्रीडम, एनकरेजमेंट, अप्रिसिएशन एंड लव ब्रिंग्स द जॉय. फाइन, नाउ विल सी वन. We create environment, at Rushikul we create environment where children are given freedom and encouragement for learning. Okay? And we'll see one Finland movie. Finland is the number one in education in the world. We'll see a short movie only.
So here's what happened. Back in the day, Finland's schools sucked on the level that ours suck on. When they tested the world's kids, both Finland and us were usually about the same, you know, somewhere down the list of nations. But Finland didn't like that. So they tried some new ideas, and in no time, Finland shot to the top of the world. Their students were number one. How did they do that? That was the one question I wanted an answer to, and I went straight to see the enemy's Minister of Education. Before I could say anything, she blurted out their top secret.
They do not have homework.
Wait, so you reduce the homework you've given
yes.
in school?
Yes. They should have more time to be kids, to be youngsters, to enjoy the life.
So they have no homework. What if all they want to do is climb a tree?
They could climb a tree. Yeah. They can climb a tree, then they learn how to climb a tree. But they end up, while climbing a tree, probably finding out about different insects, and they can come to the school next day and tell me about what they found.
Compared to the older kids, how many hours a day do the younger ones go to school?
Mondays, 3 hours. Tuesdays, 4 hours. It varies. It's 20 hours a week.
So they're, oh, man. Now, does this 3 or 4 hours at school include the lunch hour?
Yes.
How are they learning anything? How are you getting anything done?
Your brain has to, it has to relax every now and then. If you just constantly work, 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 then you stop learning. And there's no use of doing that for a longer period of time.
Finland students have the shortest school days and the shortest school years in the entire Western world. They do better by going to school less.
Here, it's so student-centered that when we had to redo our playground, they had the architects come in and talk to the kids
Would they listen to?
Yes, yes. There are things on our playground that the students really wanted.
We tried to teach them to be happy person, to be respect others and respect yourself.
You're concerned with their happiness.
Oh yeah.
What the hell do you teach?
I teach math.
So the math teacher says the first thing out of your mouth of what you wanted these students to get out of school was to be happy, to have a happy life.
Yeah.
And you're the math teacher.
Yeah.
When do they have their time to play and socialize with their friends and grow as human beings? Because there's so much more life around than just school.
You want them to play?
I want children to play.
And that was the principle.
There's a Finland number one education in the world. So every schools are like that. What you understood? Kya samajh mein aaya? No homework was the topmost secret of that. No homework was the first secret. Then, the kids need to be kids, they need to be youngsters, they need to enjoy the life. What next? Kya bol rahe the? Yeah. What you are saying? Only 3 or 4 hours of studies, 20 hours, less schooling time. School time was less, wonderful.